this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to Let's Play Phantasy Star Generation 2, which is a remake of Phantasy Star 2, only released in Japan for the PlayStation 2. A lot of PS2s going on here, translated by the great folks such as Kyence, Tryphon, and others at the Phantasy Star Cave. I'll put a link in the description for downloading and such. I am playing on the PC SX2 emulator, which of course is a PlayStation emulator. This is version 0.8 as of now. I've been waiting for them to come out with an updated release because there are quite a few errors as far as spelling and stuff like that, formatting. Anyway, Motavia, the second planet of the Algol star system. So I decided to, you know, not to wait any longer. I was also waiting for them to come out with an English name version. It has been nearly a millennium since the evil forces of Lashik, Lassik, were defeated by Elisa, Tyrone, Lutz, and Meow. Alice, Meow, Odin, and Noah, the English names, which I prefer in most cases. Algol has since entered a prosperous age under the guidance of Mother Brain, a massive supercomputer. Peace and happiness reign supreme. I actually think the horns are a little obnoxious. I much prefer the original theme here, which is kind of like a mysterious keyboard sound. Motavia, initially a desert planet, was transformed by Mother Brain into a lush, green, agricultural world full of dome farms. Quick note, this is not a blind LP. I've played the original game. I don't think I've finished it, however. This idyllic life has led many people to forget the pain and suffering of the past. The knowledge of Elisa and her fellow hero saving Algol has faded away, a distant memory. Now that said, I haven't played this game for many, many years. Well, the original game, I've never played the remake. My apologies for the music skipping. Now, a dark evil awakens once again. Will the mysterious secret that controls the fate of Algol be uncovered? Yeah, it's messing up there. I'm using Fraps at this time. I might have to either switch recording program. I couldn't get Bandicam to work right. Anyway. So I got close to finishing the original PlayStation 2 when I was a kid. PlayStation 2. Phantasy Star 2. Anyway. Start. I'm not sure, but I don't think I ever played it. That said, call this not a blind LP, but a blurry Let's Play. Of course, the major events, most of which I do remember, some were rather sad. Including this, which I'm not going to spoil it here, in case anyone's watching this who's, you know, never seen or played the game before. Loading the clear game from Generation 1 is part one of a series of steps that you need to complete in order to resurrect someone in the game who meets an untimely demise. I'm not going to say who. But in order to do that, you not only need to do this step, load the clear game, but you need to finish the entire Generation 2 game and then load that game into here as well. I'm not sure if it's at this step or if it asks you for something else. So I'm not going to be doing that. Number one, I don't want to play the game twice over. Number two, there's really, although it's really sad, many have said the game is unbalanced by bringing that character back, and it takes away from the dramatic effect. If anyone feels the same way as when Jean Grey was brought back after being killed in the Dark Phoenix saga and then brought back 5 years later to be an X-Factor. Yeah, number one, I was kind of glad she was back, and then number two, I was kind of not really glad that she was back, because that was cheesy. But anyway, so we're not going to go this route. I'm just going to play through the game. Hope anyone's not too disappointed. Anyway, I've been having terrible nightmares. I forgot I have to press through these. In them, a young girl is fighting an eldritch demon. I'm not sure if this is a spoiler for me to tell. I mean, anyone who's played the first Phantasy Star game or the Phantasy Star Generation 1 remake knows who this is. I watch them battle, but I can't move or speak. All I can do is helplessly look on as the girl is attacked. As always, I wake up just as she's exhausted all her strength. I'm now in my bedroom, dimly lit by the early dawn. There's a lot of text here, guys, just, you know, in the beginning here. There's another two more sequences like this. An indescribable grief consumes me. I desperately hold back the tears in my eyes. This is the modern age under the auspices of the supercomputer Motherbrain. This is not the time to dwell on the nonsense of dreams. Such fanciful notions have been replaced by world-encompassing digital data. Sounds rather dehumanizing. Can't have dreams anymore, that's just digital data. I open my window and take a breath of fresh air. The crisp morning breeze courses through my body, washing away any ill feelings left from my nightmare. My name is Eusis. I hate that name. Rolf is the name for the game that was released in North America, anyway. And that's not much better, but Eusis? If I'm even saying it right. I'm an agent of the Matavian government here in the capital, Paseo. I specialize in swordsmanship. Brief town theme, which I actually like. Governor O'Connor. Good morning, Eusis. My apologies for calling you in so suddenly. Now, I'm going to put a link. They came out with a series of, well, they call them text adventures, but they are actually graphical adventures that were released only in Japan, once again translated by some great people. And technically, I think they were released for the Game Gear? I don't even remember. But I did play those games. They give background for all 8 characters. So, including Eusis, Nay, these are the English names, Rudolph or Rudo, Amy, Hugh, Anna, Josh, and Sheer, Eusis, no, I messed that up. Sorry, guys. Eusis is the Japanese name. Those are the American names. Japanese names are Eusis, Nay, Rudger, Anne, Huey, Amia, Kyence, and Shilka. Strange names. So those are names we're going to be seeing here. Anyway, my apologies for calling you in so suddenly. How can I be of service, Governor O'Connor? Governor O'Connor, you mess up the music. You've been working for me about 2 years now? Yes. I am forever grateful for you taking an orphan like me under your wing and making me an agent, sir. No, I simply gave you the opportunity. You became an agent on your own merits. I guess. Moving on. What I am going to ask of you will be the toughest and by far the most important mission you've ever done. It is crucial to the future of Motavia. As you well know, I'm not exaggerating when I say Algol's rapid development is solely due to Mother Brain. Part of my duty is to oversee Mother Brain's development plans for Motavia. Afforestation has been progressing smoothly, and I have no doubt it was for the best. By the way, guys, this is one of the few songs that really closely resembles the original. Well done, I approve. But now, biomonsters flagrantly roam Motavia. Why do they exist? How can we stop them? We have to find the answers to these questions. Eusis, your mission is to recover the system recorder from the biosystems lab. The system recorder? Yes, the system recorder. It's evident that the biosystems lab experienced an accident 2 years ago. By analyzing the system recorder, we can conduct a proper investigation into what transpired. We must find a way to control these biomonsters. I think we'll find a solution once the system recorder is recovered. But wasn't an agent sent to investigate the source of the accident when it first happened? You mean Shelley? Unfortunately, she never reported her findings.
What?
A report from Data Memory indicates she ceased all communications 2 weeks ago. Does that mean... She's a skilled agent. However, I must admit, I am concerned. I presume something unusual must have happened. Eusis, can I entrust this mission to you?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. I sincerely hope you safely recover the system recorder and find Shelley. I'm not recording that, but I'm not controlling that, by the way. Girl with long ears. Eusis! Where have you been? I was so worried. Now, her ears are really exaggerated in this for some reason. Sorry. Governor O'Connor needed to see me about an urgent matter. Did you sleep well, Nay? You're always such a late sleeper.
You lied. You promised me you'd never, ever leave me alone.
Nay?
Stupid, Eusis.
Now, what is it here? He can't leave the house? Ever? I mean, are they Siamese twins now, or what? See what I mean about the ears? It's just out of control. Way out of proportion, at least in that shot. Too wide.
Nay says, what?
What's wrong?
Nay, did you know you have the most expressive eyes? You're staring at me the same way you did when we first met.
What?
6 months have passed since that day.
You look so strange with your pointy cat-like ears. People hated them and persecuted you, forcing you to be a vagabond when you were just a little girl. They almost killed you.
Yes, this actually points back to the Phantasy Star text adventure for Nay. Each of them were like... His one eye looks bigger than the other a little. Each of them were like about an hour and a half to 2 hours long. A lot of fun.
Eusis. When I first met you, you were so young, Nay. And now? Now I see that you've grown up to be a wonderful young woman.
Uh-huh.
Eusis, why did you bring all that up just now?
Hmm?
Governor O'Connor asked me to investigate the Biosystems Lab.
Hmm?
Biosystems Lab? My mission is to recover the system recorder. Also...
What is it?
To find the previously assigned agent who has gone missing.
Previous agent?
Yeah. Do you mean Miss Shelley, your childhood friend?
Gah! I hate this! You want to go alone, don't you, Eusis?
Nay, an agent disappeared.
This mission is very dangerous. I don't want to put you in harm's way.
Do you understand?
Eusis?
So, this is goodbye for a while. I'm sure you'll do just fine without me around.
Even though it was only for a short time, it was fun having you around, Nay. You're like a sister to me.
Oh, in the sister zone.
Liar.
Hmm?
You're a liar. Didn't you promise you'd never leave me? Was that a complete lie?
Nay.
Please, Eusis, please take me with you. I'll do anything, Eusis.
Anything?
Nay. You... Please, oh please, Eusis.
Sleeping late during the mission is strictly prohibited, okay?
Hmm?
Eusis!
I'm not alone anymore. Eusis, I'll always be by your side, no matter what happens.
Now, about 15 minutes in, we are finally given control. Now, this town song, I actually really like, but it's a little too energetic for a town song. I mean, this is like screaming with energy. I do really like it though, you know, on its own. It's a lot different from the original. Okay, so we got stuff here. There's Eusis and Ney, of course, at level 1. There's their stats, equipment. I'm actually just seeing this for the first time. I really like the colors. Nice. Carbon suit and knife. So he's... leather shoes. Okay, so he already has this stuff on, right? Nay has a ribbon. Fashion accessory. Designer fabric. Carbon vest. Bodice made from carbon fiber woven into jersey cloth. Espadrilles, which are fashionable sandals. Nay had them custom made. And a steel claw. Claw with steel blades, light and strong. Okay, just figuring out how to get out of this. Oh! Now, if you consult, the biosystems lab, my mission is to recover the system recorder and investigate the accident. This will not be easy. So this is a way to get your characters to talk to each other. Sometimes they give out what could be valuable clues at certain intervals. First, let's gather all of the necessary equipment we'll need. Nay doesn't have anything to say at this point. Now the techniques I have to learn, obviously we don't have any. Oh, Nay has one. Recovers 20 hit points of one ally. Ugh. Rester. Okay, those are items which we're all wearing. Order's fine. Battle scenery. We can switch to original. Hype display. Ooh, I might want to turn that off. I'm guessing this is in the dungeons. In the original game, they have pipes, you know, showing off their, you know, their multiple layers of scrolling. They had pipes on the ceiling, and you could barely see your characters, you know, because the pipes would be on top. And, yeah, if we can turn that off, that'd be great. I'm guessing that's what that means. I'm not completely sure. Message speed to fast. Okay, now we just wander around and talk to people. Occur. Hannah says, don't go to the North Bridge. There's a man named Darum there who kills anybody that tries to cross it. Sometimes they say different things. Darum? He's an infamous hunter who's gone rogue. He kills as many innocent people as he does biomonsters. There used to be a facility in this city called the Sword Gym where you could learn the art of swordsmanship. It was demolished last year. I really wanted to learn how to use a sword. Try to talk to everybody. Jack says, head to the Central Towers Library to learn anything you need to know about Motavia. Shh, keep your voices down. Have you heard about the Rascals? They're a group of hunters gone bad. Avoid them. You know what's good for you. Isn't this city peaceful? I'm really glad I moved here from Aramaya.
Aramaya, the rascals, a group of hunters, have rampaged the city. I couldn't stand living there anymore. Is that even correct that they rampaged the city? I'm not sure if that's even correct sentence structure. Moses says it hasn't rained at all lately. The lake is bone dry. I really don't want to know what the heck is going with Amadas. The afforestation plan was going so smoothly. It's really worrisome. Okay, that's out. Hey, guess what? I'm gonna be a thief when I grow up. Nay says, what? No way, there's nothing cool about that. Understand? Yeah, I get it. Hey lady, I've been thinking about what you said. You're right. I have to have a bigger and better dream. That's why I'm gonna become the king of thieves. Gah! Am I supposed to press these symbols? Because I'm not using actual PlayStation controller with the symbols. You know, I actually want to press them. I have to get a diagram of the controller and see if I can do that. My buttons just say 1, 2, 3, and 4. Edna says, even women have to pick up weapons and fight now. That reminds me, I have to go buy some for myself. Are you prepared for your trip? Not yet, I guess. Why are there biomasters? I really hate those things. Talk to her already. Talk to him. Luckily, these people don't walk far, I don't think. Sale says, this planet flourished due to the biosystem's lab, but now it creates monsters that are destroying it. Ironic, isn't it? I figured it out. Those biomonsters were created by scientists conducting genetic experiments. They're only supposed to create plants and animals that are suited for this environment. They must have been conducting these experiments right under our noses for a long time. Scary to think about. Pat says, I heard that if you go to the North Bridge, a man named Darum will rob you of all your money. Apparently, Darum joined the Rascals. I guess that means he's gone rogue. Gone rogue. My dad just sits around all day, doing nothing because he doesn't have to work for a living. My mom doesn't do anything because she doesn't have to work for a living. That's out. Tabitha says, if you have money, you can clone your own body parts at the clone lab. Isn't that neat? It's actually kind of weird. Unfortunately, it won't work if the cells are too damaged. How scary is that? Titus says, well, well, don't you look gallant. Remember to equip everything or it'll be wasted. The outside world is crawling with biomonsters. Bring some medicine with you for peace of mind. Yeah, we need that. I don't want to just rely on Nae's power. Probably isn't going to be able to use it very often. Hyman? I used to work in the biosystems lab located west of the lake, but that was a long time ago. Biosystems lab? They were conducting some complex research there. Then an accident occurred and it was shut down. I lost my job. Do you have anything you can offer me? I do good work. Nope. Nothing to offer. We talk to him. This is the problem. We talk to. Nope, I don't think so. Raven says this is Paseo, the capital of planet Motavia, as well as its largest city. When you leave town, head through the Paseo passageway, then head southeast to find the city of Aramea. Is this that old guy we talked to? I think think he's an old guy? Figured it out, yeah. I just want to make sure we talk to everybody. Isabel says, hunters are so cool. They are so strong and reliable. What do hunters do? They hunt the biomonsters, of course. Seriously, how could you not know that? Okay, I thought she was asking for it. Okay, so this is where we heal ourselves. Doctor says, hello. Are you ill? Nope. Welcome to the clone lab. Do you need to revive someone? But you're not really getting them back, you're just getting their clone. It's the tool shop. Welcome. Are your preparations complete? Double check. We only have 200. Monomate. No, I think if we hit... No. Okay, I used to be able to hit something to get a description. I think it was the up. Whatever the up button is. Hesitant Ocarina, Traveling Ocarina. Okay, this is what brings you probably to different cities or back out of dungeons, that kind of thing. I'm not gonna buy anything yet, but soon. I think this is our home. Let's relax a bit at home. Not much else happening here. Should we leave now? No? Right, let's check and make sure there are no problems. Storage? Oh. So we could store stuff in here. That's pretty cool. I didn't know that. I did not know that. Okay. Weapons and armor. Look at her hair. Welcome. Nervous about your upcoming journey? Alright, I'll show you some weapons that'll put you at ease. I like this theme too. Alright, so we only have 200. I could get a knife and a steel claw and then have nothing left, or just get either one. What kind of knife do we have? I have a knife. Now I might be able to get a second one. And a second steel claw, possibly. Let's go next door first. This isn't your run-of-the-mill shop, because our protective gear is totally different. No window shopping. My god. Headgear. Carbon suit, carbon vest, carbon shield. Okay, we see who can use that stuff. I don't think I'm getting any armor right now. Believe it or not. What kind of carbon? We have carbon suit already. Alright. This stuff is, at this point, it's relatively expensive. Let's get another steel claw, I guess, for her. I'm pretty sure she can have two. Nice. One, 20 meseta left, so... Let's buy just several monomates. One more. What I'm thinking is that at this point, a dime is probably going to heal more than our total hit points, so it would be kind of a waste. At least, if I remember right, that's the way it was in the first game. Running out of time! Okay, so we've been there, That's our home, that's the item shoppy. And... that's the dude. We've been here. I think that's a library. Okay, so we got these two to go to next, so I think one's the library and one's, this is a city hall, I think, up here, and that's the library. So yeah, stay tuned. Thanks for watching, hope to see you in the next episode, and yeah, endure. And enduring, grow strong.